our rights come from avoidance of pain. Avoidance of pain.
So the way the AC works is that because all actions, courses of right action, have to be underlined by a certain sense of goodness, AC says that sense of goodness is pain. If animals feel pain, then they are considered within moral theory. That means that when agents
decide
to act rightly or wrongly,
the reason AC gives
animal
rights is because pain is something that we ought to be avoided, and beings that can feel that pain should not be like treated in a bad way and like give them pain in certain ways. That's why we have rights to protect them from feeling that pain, right?
Right. Rights protect against pain. Rights acknowledge that the pain that they feel is normatively significant.
Oppression undermines justice for three reasons. First, oppression is defined by the Collins Leadership Training as acts of subjugation by cruelty or force, and by definition, oppression deprives those subjugated from their due, since they receive undue harm from their oppressors. Second, oppression precludes due treatment in a situation from exclusion or which within job assigned to act, which goes from the hospital, and ensure that in-groups act toward outgrowth and by rules of right conduct. Third, questions of justice arise when the interests of two parties conflict in such cases. The most basic requirement of any system of due is that weighs the interests of all involved equally, since if the prosecution excuses me for one party under oppression, there's no guarantee that others do their due. The NC does not question whether animals deserve good treatment, but it comes to criticism of the rights approach advocated by the AC. The K criticizes rights extension as restricting the power of hierarchy worthy, rather than people practice jumping over who are rights holders and remaining unchallenged and assumed an extension of animal rights. The species paradigm preserves the oppression of groups deemed unworthy of rights with animal right advocacies, adopting criteria that are human subjective rights subjected to the group in power and treating their supremacy. That as thus the NC rejects animal rights by questioning whether the rights approach ought to be used at all. Act 1 is the impacts. A. Rights approach presents the hierarchy of power as the root cause of exclusion and oppression by groups and power. The boundary between who has rights and who doesn't, between who are oppressors and who are oppressed, still exists in the right of group and power to determine who gets rights unchallenged. Capital 1. The problem is that an animal rights approach to the different animals as the basis from on which they wish to secure rights is no different from what they were previously denied. The same hierarchy of a category is presupposed. Only boundary those included within the rights is extended downward, while the latter shown by exclusionary boundary The idea of the ladder categories remains unchallengeable in challenges the power of the original proven power. Since you see yourself entering the top of the ladder, you enter yourself the right to decide over the rights of others, the infinite species paradigm. Thus, rights are central rather than software exclusion into the oppression of the group of power, whose authority deciding who are oppressors and who are oppressors unquestioned, the infinite boundary that justifies oppression of those without rights has only been shifted, not destroyed. But even extending rights to certain groups does not suffer the oppression since the original group of power, so the supremacy deserves rights and can withdraw the rights boundary at any time. Capital 2. What men in their endeavor to debunk the right supremacy use to draw the blind to find human and thus rights between men and women on the basis of natural hierarchy, the place of sex of women on the stage of the law, opposed to animal struggles for the emancipation of women, that determines how the balance should be reshuffled for the white man's membership, and the power to classify and grant rights was unaffected. Emancipation may have led to their inclusion into category of humans, yet without having become equal to the white men, who completes the occupied category exclusively, the boundary has been shifted downward, yet the idea of hierarchy within supremacy of the group at the top has been left unshaken. Thus, the extension of rights leads to the entire hierarchy of power that causes oppression with the original group, so the power to determine who are rights holders is true, especially with animal, extension of animal rights. Capital 3. To signal exclusion of humans among animals, the interest of promoting animals in the past with those serving rights equally leads to hierarchy and tax going up instead of dichotomy between animals and non-animals and crucial boundaries still exist. Any question simply at what precise point shall for now be fixed. Thus, exclusion of boundaries will only be removed from humans versus animals to animals versus non-animals, but the group of power is unchallenged in its definition of who are rights holders. Extension of animal rights does not address the hierarchy of power, but rather accepts the oppressive framework as its basis. And the animal rights advocacy is two terms of hierarchy of power, since either A relies uncritically on the division of animals into their own subcategories and advocating extension of rights only to certain species, or B interests the supremacy of the group of power since the criteria to judge whether animals are rights holders are assumed with human subjective. Capital 4. The species subdivision of animals into different species has led the animal rights advocacy to move animals on the level of humans are trying to achieve, overcome, to maintain evolutionary hierarchy and grant rights to some but not others on the basis of zoological differences in the primates but not to worms. D. Zoological classification includes criteria concerning social political coexistence of animals and humans. All the perspective classification masquerades as identity and no single at all. It reflects a human subjective. Crucial principles of hierarchy are the animal and species alleged similarity or difference with humans or from humans. The evolutionary order. The subjective norm of evaluation has been incorporated within very options of being constituted. Thus, the criteria to justify animal rights to be the oppressive species mindset will qualify them as rights holders similar to group and power evidenced by the topic literature of animals that prove animals have sentience, consciousness, and moral reasoning, the hallmarks of a typical human being. Thus, the AC accepts uncritically the oppressive mindset of rights extension by advocating existing his pain argument. Then, this KST negative pronouncement is one of the few sources of negative offensive core topic that animals lack sentience, moral rationality, is only defense against whether justice ought give animal rights and does not generate reasons why justice ought not give animal rights. This case uniquely gives next reason why justice rejects the rights approach, grounded speed of fairness, and gives equal ability to generate offense, acts of balance, and experience of bad graph, and the ability to have substantive clash. Act 2 is the link. First, the AC advocates extension of rights to animals, the strongest link to hierarchy of power, the negative truth has been imprisoned in the rights approach. Second, discussion of sentience and any kind of value via the negative system of rights concept. Tackler 5. Whether the criterion for animal rights not be sentience judged from a human point of view or life worth living has nothing to do with challenging the power hierarchy, they simply aim to adjust the position in the middle, leaving the hierarchy as such intact. It is not speciesism that is being challenged, but merely the content of categories constituted by speciesism. Even the most radical animal rights positions is no different in theory from that which denies such rights. Not only does it need a crucial boundary short between animals and non-animals, but it continues to arrogate itself the right to grant rights. Neither does it help if we speak of intrinsic value, rather than fundamentally relational category, which implies possibly of a lack of value. The very project of granting and extending rights as fundamental species, accepting a human agent and judge into category subject ruling over object world. The AC bites into decay, they adopt a higher extension of rights and enter the defensive rule of the group in power. Act 3 is alternative. The alternative is to reform our question from who deserves rights to how to stop power abuse by groups at the top of the hierarchy. Only a shift away from the rights mindset and even attempt to solve back for oppression and intrinsic rights approach. Capital 6. The question of how who else apart from humans shall have rights or consider be rights, the question is how the massive abuse of power by specific groups of humans, their exploitation and destruction of lives of others, can be stopped. Talking of extension of rights to other groups and species, mass what humans have been exercising are not any rights to life and survival, but the power of groups to dominate, exploit, and destroy others. They are the very reason why protecting the rights of the majority of people, animals, and nature become a necessity. The rhetoric of rights disguises the position of the subject. The shared scientific perspective, the common focus on objects, the objects of exploitation of rights, that suddenly disappear from you. Thus, the only way to solve oppression is to stop oppressing violently and oppressed. The only reason rights are perceived necessary is because we accept oppression and domination to exist and try to solve by extending rights only rejection of hierarchies and power to solve oppression. Capital 7 clarifies. A radical creature speciesism will lead us to question universal human rights. A radical creature power would imply necessarily abolishing rather than affirming a right to freedom. A concept developed by a leading culture of power is required is a fundamentally different human attitude towards reality, and attitude is not premised on human subject in relation to an object world, and the human right to domesticate, exploit, and destroy. Violation of animals cannot be rectified by wider zoning and protection. It can only be solved by stopping the violators violating. We need a radical political struggle against the so-called rights of the powerful. It is not challenged by the extension of animal rights. The definition of rights defines non-rights. Thus, the only way to solve for oppression is to reject hierarchies of power and intrinsic oppressor to oppressed relationship. Only once people take the first step to realize that rights and entrench hierarchies can reform be made to challenge oppression and solve from reaction of power, hierarchies, and policies and actions, rather than faking solvency with rights extension. Only when each human takes personal responsibility to reject oppressive acts can we break the cycle of oppression and entrenched rights approach. So, we reject the AC since justice can require oppression justified rights approach, justified rights approach, and NC solves. Go to the AC. Often termed commerce resolution, remember, I'm defending commerce resolution because I'm just rejecting animal rights and as being unjust because of rights extension. Moreover, often Nash, he is misconstruing Nash. Nash